Electro discharge machining (EDM) is a machining method primarily used for hard metal or those that would be very difficult to machine with traditional technique. EDM especially work with materials that are electrically conductive, although method of machining insulated ceramic with EDM have been proposed. EDM can cut intricate contours or cavities in hard bent steel without the need of heat treatment or soften and rearming them. Method can be used with any other metal or metal alloy such as titanium, hostalloy, cobalt, and inconel. Also, application of this process to shape polycrystalline diamond tools. This is EDM system. Current control, rectifier, servo control, and movable. This is workpiece, dielectric tool, and EDM component. The main component of EDM: electric power supply, dielectric medium, workpiece and tool, servo control unit. The workpiece and tool are electrically connected to a DC power supply. Current density in the discharge of the channel is of the order of 10,000 ampere per centimeter square, and the power density is 500 megawatt per centimeter square. Gap known as spark gap, the range of 0.005 mm to 0.05 mm is maintained between the workpiece and the tool. Dielectric slurry is forced through this gap at a pressure of 2 kgf per centimeter square. This is EDM component, constant gap, servo mechanism, dielectric system, and power supply paid for pulse current and workpiece holding system. Working principle: it is a process of metal removal based on the principle of material removal by the intricate electric spark discharge between the electro tool and the workpiece. EDM is a potential difference applied between the tool and the workpiece. Both tool and work material are to be conductors. It is essential requirement. The tool and work material are immersed in a dielectric medium. Generally, kerosene or ionized water is used as a dielectric medium. The gap is maintained between the tool and the workpiece. Depending upon the applied potential difference, 50 to 450 volt, and the gap between the tool and the workpiece, an electric field will be established. Generally, the tool is connected to negative terminal and the workpiece positive. As the electric field is established between tool and the job, a free electron on the tool are subjected to electrostatic force. If the bonding energy of the electron is less, electrons would be emitted from the tool. Such emission of electrons are called as term as cold emission. The cold emitted electrons are then accelerated towards the job through the dielectric medium. As they gain velocity and energy and start moving towards the job, there would be a collision between the electrons and the dielectric molecules. Such collision may result in ionization of the dielectric molecules. Ionization depends on the ionization energy of the dielectric molecules and the energy around. As the electron get accelerated more positively, ion and electron would be get generated due to collision. This cyclic process would increase the concentration of electron and ion in the dielectric medium between the tool and the job at the spark gap. The concentration would be so high that the matter existing in the channel could be characterized as a plasma. The plasma is a breakup of molecules in proton, electron, and neutron. The electrical resistance of such plasma channel be very less. Thus, all of sudden, a large number of electrons will flow from a tool to a job and ions from the job to tool. This is called avalanche motion of electrons. Such movement of electrons and ion can be visually seen as a spark. Thus, the electrical energy is dissipated as the thermal energy of the high-speed electron then impinge on the job ion on the tool. The kinetic energy of the electrons and ions on impact with the surface of the job and the tool respectively would be converted into thermal energy of heat flux. Such intense ionized heat flux leads to extreme instantaneous constant rise in temperature, which would be in the axis of 10,000 degrees centigrade. Such localized extreme rise in temperature leads material removal. The material removal occurs due to instant vaporization of the material as well as due to melting. The molten metal is not removed completely but only creates compression shock waves on the both the electrode and surface, particularly at high spots on the workpiece surface, which are closest to the tool. This evacuates molten material and forms a crater around the site of the spar. The whole sequence of operation occurs within a few microseconds. From this diagram, you can see there is a spark and the removal of material in a microsecond. Tool holder, servo control tubing, dielectric flow, fixture, workpiece, DC pulse generator.